everyone. Hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we're going to learn a concept that is on security market line. This concept exactly, it comes into picture when you're trying to evaluate the portfolio management of different stocks. Now, as you can see, there's a graph over here which is visible. See, what is security market line? You can see the line over here which is written, but what exactly does it mean? See, SML, that is the security market line, is basically a graphical representation of the capital asset pricing model. Now, what is your capital asset pricing model? It is as simple as that. Your cost of equity, the amount of the cost that you need to pay to your equity shareholders, right? So you calculate your KE based on the CAPM method, and this is the representation of the CAPM. SML gives an expected return of the market at the different level of the systematic or the market risk, and it is also called as the characteristics line, where X represents the beta, that is the systematic risk, beta, risk of the asset, and the Y axis represents the expected return, ER, right? So over here, above the security market line, you see undervalued stocks. That means a buy signal. And below the security market line, you have overvalued stocks, which shows as the sell signal. Because over there, you cannot go further. It's going to go down. It's overvalued. So the security market line equation goes something like this. SML is equal to your expected return, which is equal to RF, that is the risk-free rate, plus your beta. Okay, you open the bracket, okay, the big one over there, you have expected return from the market, ERM, less the RF, that is the risk-free rate, and you close the bracket. This is your SML. Okay, so in this above security market line, you see ER is the expected rate of return. As you can see, expected rate of return. RF is the, over here, this is not EF, this is RF. Okay, this is RF, that is risk-free rate. Then you have beta, which is the sensitivity of the stock, which is non-diversifiable or systematic risk, and the most important factor of SML. And ERM is basically the expected return on the market portfolio. And finally, you have RF, which is known as or ERM minus RF. This whole thing is also known as your market risk premium. The above security market line equation can be graphically also be represented. You can see how the graphical representation has been done. Market risk premium, ERM minus RF, that is your risk-free rate, is down. You can see the straight line. M is the market portfolio. This is the security market line. You have above undervalued stocks and below as overvalued stocks. Expected return over here on the y-axis and systematic risk on the x-axis. Let's understand some characteristics of the same. See, SML is a good representative of investment opportunity cost, which provides a combination of, it's a combo of, you can say, a risk-free rate, that is your RF, and the market portfolio. Okay, second, zero beta security or zero beta portfolio has an expected return on the portfolio which is equal to RF. Okay, third, the slope of SML is determined by the market risk premium, which is ERM minus your RF. That is risk premium. Higher the market risk premium, steeper the slope, and vice versa the case. Fourth, the assets which are above SML are basically, you can say, overvalued, as they have lower expected return for the same amount of the risk. Then the next thing that you have is security market line example, which we are going to understand. Let's say that the risk-free rate, RF, is 5%, okay, and the expected market return, ERM, is, let's say, 14%. consider there are two securities, one with a beta, okay, one with a beta of 0.5. Let's say there is security A and there's security B. Let's just take above control X, control V. You have beta of two companies, and this is going to remain the same, control V, control R. Okay, so your beta for the two security, let's say 0.5 and 1.5, right? So now let's understand the security market line example, calculating the expected return on each security using SML. See, the expected return for security A as per the security market line is as simple as that, is equal to your risk-free rate, that is 5%, plus you will multiply 0.5 into 9, okay? That is 14 minus 5. You can, or I'll just do it in bracket, 14 minus 5, that is your ERM minus RF. So that's 9.5, okay? And in the similar fashion, you can find for this is equal to 5%, that is the risk-free rate, plus 1.5, that is the beta, as you can see, into 9, that is again the same thing, there's no change. So you can see there is a significant change just because of the beta, 0.5 and 1.5. 9.5 and 18.5, you can see the significant level of difference just because of the change in the beta. Higher the beta has led to higher amount of the cost of, basically, the cost of equity. Now, what is the important measure in the security market line? What is the important measure in the security market line? See, beta is important measure in the security market line. Thus, let's discuss in detail. You know, beta is a measure of volatility of the systematic risk or security of the portfolio as compared to the market as a whole. So, the market can be considered as an indicative market index or a basket of universal assets. If your beta, if that is equal to 1, then the stock has the same level of risk of the stock to the market. A beta greater than 1 represents that the stock has greater than 1 represents a riskier asset than the market, and beta less than 1, when we say that if beta is less than 1, that represents that risk is less than the market, right? And beta can be calculated by a very simple formula, that is the covariance of X and Y, or let's say the risk from the market and the risk from the stock, divided by the variance of market. You can say variance of the RM, that is of the market, or you can, this can be written as the correlation, which is a P, you can say MS, okay? You will multiply this into your standard deviation, SD of stock upon SD of market. That is the standard deviation of the market. Let's understand some of the advantages and some of the disadvantages of security market line. See, security market line is very easy to use. SML and CAPM can be easily used to model and derive expected return from the asset of the portfolio. Second, the model assumes that the portfolio is well diversified, hence it neglects the unsystematic risk, making it easier to compare two diversified portfolio. Third, CAPM and SML considers systematic risk and which is neglected by other models like dividend discount model and weighted average model. So based on this, we can make some final conclusion. SML gives the graphical representation of the capital asset pricing model to give expected return for the systematic or the market risk. Fairly priced portfolio like SML, while undervalued and overvalued stock, okay, portfolio lies between the below and below the line respectively. A risk-averse investor, you can say that investment is more often to lie close to the y-axis or the beginning of the line, wherever risk taker investors investment would be higher on the SML. And SML provides a good method for comparing the two investments or securities. However, the same depends on the assumptions of the market risk, risk-free rate and the beta coefficients.
If you have learned and, you know, liked the video, if you think that, you know, if you have enjoyed and learned watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.